came as a surprise to many, or to the controversy that has consumed those that have attempted to steer the war against Kraft in the position he has now assumed. And many still question the personality of the man that now chairs EACC. Nothing bad with his personality, really. Archbishop Eliud Wabukala, what do you think of his appointment? Do you think he will succeed in the war against Kraft? Talk to us on 2422 and on Twitter using the hashtag SundayLive. Archbishop Eliud Wabukala, thank you so much for making time for us tonight. It's been a few days on the job already. Nothing really, it's not enough to talk about experience, really. But how has it been so far for you?
Thank you so much, Mr. Hussein. First, welcome in the studio. I want to say that it has been good. Mm-hmm. Just like many Kenyans who think that integrated house is just a place where, you know, people are not good, and it's very threatening. Mm-hmm. I can assure you that I reached there and was welcomed. Mm-hmm. I've met staff who are very hardworking and enthusiastic to support and help Kenya. And so far, it is a good place.
Okay.
And therefore, let that thinking that things there are just too bad. It's actually made up of wonderful Kenyans, young people, talented, all the people experienced. They are all out to serve Kenya.
Right.
Just give them a word of pongezi. You know, they need to be pat on the back.
Right.
Let's not bash them every day.
Okay, but many, of course, talk about the problem being external forces, and I'll come to that.
Yes.
There was a problem, really, with not many people applying for this job. Mm. Why did you apply for this job? Why did you want to do this job?
Well, it's interesting, because when many people didn't apply, and then again, they called, not many were coming, something just told me. Well, I was just back at my home, mm-hmm. and I said, maybe God is saying I should try this one. Because I have that feeling that this country needs to be worked for. We want to leave a generation, a future for our children that is good. And so I felt I was actually convinced that this is the job perhaps God wants me to do. And so I drafted my application. Mm-hmm. Basically, it's like I felt convicted that if I don't apply and nobody does it, I will not live with peace. After all, why can't I put my life on the line for the sake of my country?
Are you ready to do that?
And I'm ready.
That's what many people are asking.
I'm ready.
Many people talking about your personality. And like I said, there's nothing wrong with your personality. You are among the few people with very good personalities in this country and in the world. You're saying you're ready to put your life on the line for this?
That's right.
Why do you say that? Because you know it's
now,
very difficult?
Well, may I define the work that I've taken? Mm-hmm. People have a very wrong conception about corruption. They describe it as a dragon, as if it is something external which is coming to hit you, and therefore you need a strong person to fight it. No, it is a matter of the heart. And basically, it's called ethics and anti-corruption. We have put only one part, too much profiled, mm-hmm. fighting, taking people to court. People are begging for blood of those who have taken their property. But we have left one thing, Hussein, the ethics part. That's the background of what can make a good nation.
Okay.
Looking at my work, I noticed that almost three quarters of the assignment is to create a strong ethical ground for Kenya. And those who actually fall by the wayside on this, then they meet the law. I think this is a time that we need all of us to come together,
okay.
and support the commission.
You say there's been a lot of focus in terms of prosecution,
yes.
and arrests,
yes.
and prosecution, mm. and conviction, but we haven't had a lot of convictions.
Let me assure you, there are many. Right now, as I speak, I've looked at the files. The last 2 months or so, we have almost 900 in court, and convictions will be coming.
Right.
Yeah.
But that is where the problem has been. As much as you say, there's been a lot of focus there.
Yes.
It's not the first time you're talking about corruption. You're saying when you applied for this job, you felt the need to come and do this, meaning corruption has been bothering you for a long time.
Yes.
Do you share Kenyans' concerns that as much as people's EACC and the government has been talking about corruption, fighting corruption, prosecution, arrest and prosecution, nothing really much has come out of that?
Well, I know people are frustrated, and rightly so. It's because there's too much talk about corruption in this country. The newspapers are talking, the radio stations are talking, and therefore too much talk about corruption has made it a very big thing.
But it's not a big problem, is it?
So it has become a big problem, psyched in people's mind, and that's why you will expect a lot of success. But I think we can still fight corruption. People should not lose hope. You know, when you lose hope, then you lose the war. What has happened is that we have profiled corruption to look so big that it creates fear.
Is it about making a, I mean, with all due respect to how you're looking at it, but is it about profiling it to look big, or is it a big problem in Kenya? It's arguably, among the biggest problems in this country, facing this country.
May I say it's not big as an external factor. It's big because it's in us. And if each one of us, as a Kenyan, took it as part of their problem, because I was saying, before you decide to cheat and take the money, you think about it. As an individual, you plan, and therefore the war can be won. We need to demystify that fact and bring it at even a family level. If you allow me perhaps to give an example of the ethical standards that I've seen in other countries. I visited Mauritius, and while there with the company I had gone with, we had a wonderful service. The Prime Minister and the rest were there, and then they said, let us take a photograph. The people from Kenya I host with wanted to carry their handbags, and they were ladies. Want to go with them, but we were told, leave them in the tent. You know, they will spoil your photo. But we wondered, how can I leave my... We went for 40 minutes, came back, the handbags were there. Here in Kenya, in the churches, you tell people, please take care of your handbag before you come forward. Mm-hmm. How can you create that kind of culture where people are responsible? That's my work.
That's the question.
Yes.
Now, all of your predecessors... In fact, at this juncture, sorry, I'd like us to look at some of your predecessors and what they said when they were coming to do this job. Let's have a look.
Thank you.
The fight against corruption will be conducted without fear, favor, or ill will, for the sake of this country and for the sake of this generation and generations yet to be born.
We're going to be harmonizing our approach to how corruption is fought in terms of how we contribute to it. We're going to end up with a refreshed approach to how we fight corruption.
Corruption will be significantly combated and prevented only if all stakeholders discharge their respective mandates effectively.
All that they said never really came to pass. I mean, your predecessors have effectively sent in a cloud of one form or the other, from Harun Mwau to Aaron Ringera, Lumumba, Momo Matemu, recently Philip Kinisu. How and why would you expect to succeed where all of them have failed?
I was asked the same question by the MPs when they were debating me, and I said, if we all have lost hope, where do you want to take Kenya? I think time has come when all of us in Kenya should say, this war is our war. This country is our country. We cannot leave this country to go to the dogs just because we are losing it. Why can't we try this last chance? It's okay. Our war, we shall win.
Right.
Yes.
I'll quote what Nyamira Senator, when you're going for this job and you're being vetted, Nyamira Senator Kennedy Mwari said about this and why you wanted to do this job, your application. He said, and I quote him, Wabukala has made the biggest mistake of his life. Mm-hmm. He has served this country for more than 50 years as a man of God. Mm-hmm. And everybody knows that. He is heading to EACC without any background in law or finance. The perpetrators of corruption who have encroached the EACC will soil his name. What would you have to say, what would you say first to such a comment? And are you not concerned or even afraid that your legacy will be soiled? I remember even as you were being sworn in, Attorney General Githu Muigai also said the same thing. Corruption cartels fight back, and when they fight back hard.
Well, I'm glad that Kenyans know that. They know that corruption fights back. They know that my life is online, and therefore they are going to be my witnesses to support me. I want them not to let me fail. I want Kenyans to come and support me, because for the sake of our country. What legacy will it be if I leave a country that's going to the dogs because of corruption? And therefore I want to call upon all the like-minded Kenyans, the ones I've served with, to just join us together. This is a plea, and I would like to talk to the hearts of Kenyans. Change from where we have been and begin to be Kenyans with patriotism.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. We'll see how that goes, and we wish you the best of luck with that. And still on that, again, it was said, someone once said that anyone going to EACC should know that they are a dog that is expected to bark, but not to bite. And you keep talking about bringing everybody together in this war against corruption. They tried that. Your predecessors tried that. But in essence, you're being warned that any attempt to fight corruption will be strongly resisted by the graft networks. Are you aware of this?
Well, I think we have seen that happen.
With your predecessors?
I mean, not with them, but I'm just saying that corruption has been a problem, and it still remains a problem, but it's something we can win. Because I feel that if we put our stakeholders, like my predecessors have done, particularly the religious sector, and talk to their people properly, and then we follow that with systems that we have set in place. It is a long one. You know, there are two ways. Create long-term strategies and also short-term strategies so that we are able to connect them, the two, and begin to change the culture of Kenyans. And that possibly is going to help us win the war.
Okay.
Yeah.
Many people had hope when all these people have been at EACC, the chairpersons at EACC, when they were taking assuming office.
Yes.
Is there any... I mean, what do you think, or do you have a reason why you think they went wrong, perhaps, in what they did?
Not yet.
Can you fault them for anything?
Well, I don't want to talk about my colleagues. They are wonderful Kenyans. I will just do my part from where I started.
But do you see any mistakes that you would have probably wanted to correct going forward?
Well, I want us to do this, Hussein.
Or do anything differently?
This is what I want us to do. Let's make a definitive line. We have the past. I have said when I was preaching that every sinner, every saint has a past, and every sinner has a future. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
So as Kenyans, we have a past, and we know that that past is not very good. But should we remain there? My call upon all of us today, let's define the line and look at the future. And let's go to that future together. Because the past has been bad. We must correct it. And continue.
You have served this country in various capacities,
yes,
and very successfully,
yes,
and everybody knows that.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're applying for this job, there are those who are against you taking the position.
Yeah.
A number of Kenyans raised issues about it.
Yes.
You are the chair of the National Anti-Corruption Campaign Steering Committee.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the mandate of this, and I want to read it very briefly for Kenyans to understand, is to undertake a nationwide public education, sensitization, and awareness creation campaigns aimed at effecting fundamental changes in the attitudes, behavior, practices, and culture of Kenyans towards corruption.
Mm.
So it will change the attitude of Kenyans towards corruption. That was the mandate of that body.
Mm.
Now, they have said, and it's a question, fair question to be asked, if the steering committee was about awareness, hasn't it failed where you are already?
Mm-hmm.
Because it was not mainstream EACC. Because it should trigger some change in attitudes, but it really has not. Or what would you say? Going by the figures you've seen, including the latest from Transparency International, where Kenya, dropped 6 places, now 139 out of 168 most corrupt countries.
Well, I think those are perceptions. You know, what has happened is that awareness has been so great that people now talk about corruption, and that's why the perception is very high, and it's possible for researchers to pick up that percentage. What I want to say...
In terms of what... Kenya being very corrupt.
No, yeah, they are very aware.
That would mean the attitudes have not really changed.
No, attitudes, now let me come back to that. When we started a campaign, I joined as a member about 2004, and that time people would talk about chai, kitu kidogo. You know, if you are not mentioning the word corruption. I remember moving to many places. I went to Kwale, to Western, wherever, and we told people, talk about corruption, ask corruption, don't use other names. That has changed. People now talk very directly. And I remember there was a time actually they were arresting a policeman. So the awareness level, together with others who are helpless, we succeeded. But what has not happened is translating that awareness to action. And that's what we need to continue to follow up.
Okay.
Yes.
Several people have also said the Secretariat is the problem at the EACC, including recently we saw that play out between Kinesu and the Secretariat, the CEO, and the Deputy CEO at EACC.
Mm-hmm.
That whatever is done, the Secretariat has its own problems.
Mm-hmm.
Is this something you're planning to do anything about? You said you don't want to talk about the past, but it's a problem that has been there.
If I have to use the experience I've done in many other places, when you go to an organization, because the most important part for you to succeed are those people you work with. You cannot be the chairman and fight the war. It's supposed to be done by all of us. And so I want to build teamwork. And I have seen them, they are capable people. I'm sure we are able to create a team and give them internal capacity, and they will make the work very easy for all of us in Kenya. So I have been to various places with almost similar experiences, and wherever I was, we formed teams, we worked together. I hope the secretariat that I have already seen already is a wonderful group.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a lot of faith in them.
And finally, there's always been this ping-pong game between the EACC and other agencies.
Yes.
Chief Justice Maraga recently talked about this. The EACC always being blamed, and you've heard that, you've been there, you've been in this country, you know that, being blamed on short investigations. Mm-hmm. Are you planning to do anything about this? And many Kenyans have been asking, mm-hmm. when will we really finally see the big guns being convicted of corruption in this country? Will it happen under your
tenure? Actually, I've looked at that very seriously to see, I've shared with even the officers who are doing that work. And I want to assure you they're up to the task. What I think we shall do, the agencies that are all involved, I would advise that we shall not be talking our problems publicly. We can do in-house alignment so that we are able to deliver on our mandates. I think it's possible. They are doing a good job.
Mm-hmm.
They are very capable down there. So it's a matter of synergizing that and not making it a public debate, because this is our job. We basically have to meet, share our ideas, and make sure that we deliver.
Okay. Yes. You've been very strong about the ethical part.
Yes.
And still, that is why I asked this question.
Mm-hmm.
Will it happen under your tenure that we'll see the big guns finally being convicted of corruption in this country? You're saying the ethics part and changing attitudes is very important.
Yes.
Somehow that has been done also by the National Steering Committee.
Yes.
But it hasn't really changed much in terms of people being corrupt
and still
people doing this.
I think the ethical part I'm talking about is that to have Kenyans so that they will not glorify corruption. They will not be escorting people whom have been convicted to the Integrity House and singing their names, because they have seen corruption is a sin and it's a dirty game. So that they are, the people who are involved in corruption are seen as our enemies, and we put them aside.
So we expect such convictions in your tenure?
We want to do that. We want to ensure that we teach that in schools, we teach that in our mosques, in our churches, in our various professional groups, and see how we can change ourselves.
Okay.
Kenya is greater than all of us.
Eliud Wabukala, the chairman, Archbishop Eliud Wabukala, the chairman of the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission. Thank you so much, and we wish you all the best in this difficult task ahead of you. Keep talking to us, 22422, and you can also tweet us using the hashtag Sunday Live. We're back after this.